Red Dead Redemption 2 has just been released and players are already experiencing how huge the game is. Rockstar has taken single-player action-adventure games to another level with this one, and it's getting hard for us to keep track of all the activities that are available in it. Do you feel lost while playing Red Dead Redemption 2? Don't worry! I'm Wes Malik from Segment Next, and here are 10 things that will make your life easier in Red Dead Redemption 2. Your bars gain experience. The first thing you should know about Red Dead Redemption 2 is how your cores or stats work. These are the bars that you can see above your minimap and show your health, stamina, and deadeye meters. What you'll have to do with those cores is pay close attention to the meters around them. Basically, for health, the meter shows your hit points. For stamina, how much more you can run, and the same for deadeye. It shows how long you can use it. What's interesting, though, is that you can level up those cores by using them. For stamina and deadeye, this is easy. Just use them. To raise your health points, you'll have to get melee or bow kills. There might be more ways to raise your hit points, so look out for that as players uncover more of the game. Upgrade your camp. Your camp not only serves as a resting and gathering place where you can talk with your gang and play minigames, by upgrading it, you can unlock useful things to use throughout your playtime. For instance, you can upgrade Dutch's and Arthur's tents to get a fast travel to the camp option. Or you can upgrade the chicken coop to get a consumable deadeye boost. There's many things to unravel on this note, so invest some time on your camp and you shall be rewarded. Use your bandana. When you want to hide your identity, escape bounty hunters, or you're into committing a crime, you'd better do it right. That's why there's a bandana for you to use in the bottom left of your items wheel. Make use of it whenever you encounter old foes or you just want to mingle in a fight without being discovered. Sure, you won't be invisible, but that's a cool feature to make use of from time to time. Check what's in your saddlebags. Before leaving your horse behind and jump right into action, you better make sure you have everything with you. Red Dead Redemption 2 is making everything a tiny bit more realistic. You don't want your horse to die, so you better leave it a bit further behind of the fight. Before you do, though, check the saddlebags for any weapons that you might have left there and you could use. Some situations need different point of view, so create your weapon cast as best as you can before you jump right in. Loot everything. That goes without saying for every RPG. In Red Dead Redemption 2 in particular, though, looting is an essential skill. Not only will you get useful items, but you can get through the early missions with a few more bucks to spend. As we said before, you'll need to upgrade your camp so the extra money will prove useful on the long run. Take your time. Most of the times when exploring, you'll get this urge of jumping from quest to quest and forget about the side activities. You shouldn't do that, though, since there are tons of them to do in Red Dead Redemption 2. Go fishing, hunt animals, talk to people, play minigames, find Easter eggs. There's really no end to the things you can do. Whether you want to tackle those side activities after the main story or not, don't play this game in a rush. You don't know when you'll see such a polished and full game again. Invest time on your horse. Many players of Red Dead Redemption 2 will want to find the best horses to make traveling easier. That's not necessarily true, though. The best thing you can do is stick with your horse, bond with it, and get the most out of your connection. It's true that you can't keep it safe forever, and it might be caught in the crossfire at some point. When this happens, you can get a better one and bond with it from the beginning. It is what it is. Don't buy guns. Unlike many other games, Red Dead Redemption 2 doesn't encourage you to spend money on guns. There's so many other things that you can buy in the game that buying guns looks unnecessary. In fact, you'll get so many guns from the story quests that you'll feel like a fool for spending extra dollars on them. By questing, you'll get all the types of guns that you might possibly need. Remember that before you head to the next gun vendor. Talk to people. NPCs in Red Dead Redemption 2 always have something to say. Every person you encounter in the game may start an interesting conversation out of the blue. You just have to have the patience for it. Someone might point you to a certain location. Someone might give you a warning, and so on. You should go back and talk to them more than once because there might be something interesting and new to share. Tobacco can improve deadeye. One little trick that can save you a lot of struggle with deadeye is chewing tobacco. As you might already know, the DeadEye meter doesn't fill on its own, and if you like using it more than the real-time shooting, you'll need to pay close attention to it. You can find tobacco quite easily and put it in your satchel for later. Use it before your gunfights to make the most out of the DeadEye mechanic. Easy, but extremely useful. This sums up everything we could possibly advise you to do in Red Dead Redemption 2 to make your life easier. Do you have more to share with us? Feel free to comment and let all of us know. We hope you're all having great deals of fun in the game, and we'll be right back at you with more news and guides on Rockstar's new game. Until next time.